We welcome you to Constellation Field, the site of Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. Perry Miles with you as the Bluefish are about to take on the Sugar Land Skeeters in the finale of this six-game series. Hello, everyone. The Bluefish coming off a 5-2 loss against the Skeeters last night. Bluefish had a 2-1 lead at one point, actually a 2-0 lead at one point, before Paul Segura gave up his first run in 24 and a third innings of work, stemming from an attempted fielder's choice turn that he tried to throw to second base, and it was an attempt to start an inning-ending double play. It did not work. The ball was thrown to the dirt and scurried into center field. Then Paul Segura had 26 and a third total innings of no earned run baseball before he wound up falling last night. He gave up 3 runs in the 6th and another in the 7th. In taking his 4th loss of the season, he has tied Bluefish record for most consecutive scoreless innings by any pitcher. Miguel Saladin held that original record at 23 2/3 frames. Paul Segura, congratulations to him. 24 1/3 innings of work of shutout baseball before he was touched up for a run in the 4th, 3 more in the 6th, and 1 more in the 7th. Today, the Bluefish are going to go with another solid pitcher in Gilbert De La Vara. Very good option from the left side of the rubber. The Bluefish southpaw this season, 9-7 in ERA in the upper 3s. He is opposed by Scott Kazmir, who has a record of 0-6, the former big leader does, an ERA in the mid-7s. Bluefish are getting ready to take on the Skeeters in less than 15 minutes time. When we come back on the Bluefish broadcast, we're going to have starting lineups, we're going to have first pitch, and also the updated Atlantic League standings, including some of the scoreboard updates. Stay tuned. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
We believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up. Man down, because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. When you choose a great-tasting Miller Lite, you're choosing on taste. And that's the right choice, not the wrong choice. Because right is way better than wrong. You don't try to do the wrong thing. Got a wrong hand, man? I've got a cousin named Randall with clammy hands. The customer's always wrong? Well, that explains the waiter's creepy grin as I ate my toast. Two wrongs do make a wrong. So make the right choice and choose on taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth. Screwdriver. Golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork. Tuning fork. Fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing, a smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Broadcast Network, Perry Miles with you as the first pitches are being delivered by some of the fans who had an opportunity to contribute some of their resources, their time, and of course their wallet out to Skeeter Country as The Skeeters have won three of the first five matchups in this series. The Bluefish hoping to salvage a split of this series. If they aren't able to do so, the Bluefish might fall 5.5 games back because Southern Maryland and New York are playing tonight. And New York, who is supposedly a very good ball club, they are, as a matter of fact. They've won the last two championships in the Atlantic League. They're having all kinds of struggles with Southern Maryland, having lost the first two games against the Blue Crabs team that is emerging quickly. They also have a guy by the name of Dan Reichert who's coming back, and I'm sure Bluefish fans know who Reichert is, but Bridgeport needs to worry about a few other things besides how Southern Maryland is doing. They need to take care of their own business, and right now with the 22-22 record, they have 26 games remaining, assuming every game is being played in half number two. And this schedule looks like this. Somerset for six, three home, three road. It's pretty simple. Camden, four on the road, that is it. Lancaster, four road, three home. Four versus Sugar Land after tonight, all four at home. You have one more road game, that's here tonight. Southern Maryland, three, all three at home. And by the way, there is a possibility that one of the games would be made up as a result of the cancellation from a few rainouts back in the latter stages of July against the Long Island Ducks. Remember, the Bluefish finished off Long Island. Their matchups against Long Island, first week of this month, they will not be playing them for quite some time. But the Bluefish, in order to force any of that, they need to not just make up some ground, but it would have to be such that they make up the 4.5 games, and that game could determine playoff possibilities. Right now, Southern Maryland at 27-18 in half two, they have emerged as the top team in the Liberty Division, and they own the third best record in the league, only New York and Lancaster, but Southern Maryland continues to make moves towards the top in talking with a few of the Southern Maryland players and even Pat Osborne. He says he's always found element that kept them team in the game. If they got enough offense, they'd be able to win the contest. And sure enough, they've been able to produce on the offensive side against the York Revolution, coupled with their shutdown pitching. Let's take a look at for a moment, the scoreboard update courtesy of PointStreet.com and AtlanticLeague.com. The York Revolution lead the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs by a score of 1-0. Lancaster 9 and Somerset nothing in the bottom of the second. Top of the third from Long Island. Camden leads Long Island by a score of 2-1. Long Island really does not have too much to play for other than their pride and possibly getting their pieces ready for the postseason in what looks to be a showdown either between Long Island and their Ferry Cup rival Bridgeport, or Long Island and their rival from a year ago in the postseason, Southern Maryland. Those two teams look to be on their way there. Camden, all they're trying to do is make up so many games that they have to, because they don't have the kind of record that any of the others do. Camden and Bridgeport are basically in the same boat, same or similar records heading into today. 53-61 for Bridgeport, 52-61 for Camden. Bridgeport actually is 7 games back of York, and Camden is 7.5. It's going to be very difficult for the River Sharks to catch anyone in Sugarland. They have to hope that they win the division. Fourth, Otanez last night, another multiple hit game. He has 6 on the year in the early going with the Fish. Luis Lopez is the first baseman batting 5th, while James Simmons, who's riding a 19-game on-base streak, is in center field batting 6th. Luis Figueroa is the second baseman batting 7th. Brad Boyer, who seems to be hitting the ball with much more authority. Boyer at third base batting 8th, and Angel Flores gets his shot behind the plate. He's batting 9th and doing the catching for Gilbert De La Vara today, as the Bluefish left-handed pitcher has done a tremendous job during this season. He has 9 wins and 7 losses. During one stretch of time, though, he was not being provided with the kind of run support that he would need in order to win, and in diagramming exactly how many wins he could have had, he certainly could have wound up with 12, 13, or 14, as many as 14 victories this season among the decisions that he's had. And the Bluefish have had their issues trying to score these runs. They've been a little bit better in the second half, but not of late, facing off against some of the better pitching staffs in Somerset, Southern Maryland, before heading down to Skeeter Country to take on Sugar Land. It has just been a nightmare for the Bluefish to take care of the business down here. Gilbert DeLavara, fastball, curveball, and changeup, and will throw 88 to 91. Will occasionally touch 92, 93 miles per hour on the radar gun out of Tucson, Arizona, as Gary Gaetti gives his lineup card over to the home plate umpire. Jeff Dugmore, Eric Diaz is over at first base, and Matt Beaver occupies third with Willie Upshaw meeting on the other side to hand the lineup, and each of them is going to give their respective handshakes to the home plate umpire and each of the umpires as Willie Upshaw makes his way towards the batter's box. Let's take a quick look at the starting line for the Skeeters. It is Ophelio Castro, third base, bat leading off. Dominic Ramos is at shortstop, batting second, while Dionis Cesar is batting third and playing right. Three straight multiple hit games for Cesar against the Fish. It's Aaron Bates, the Manhattan, New York native, at first base, batting fourth. Bubba Bell is in center field, batting fifth, while Steve Moss occupies left field and bats sixth. Manny Mejia gets a start at the designated hitter spot, batting seventh. Iggy Suarez is the second baseman, batting eighth. And Octavio Martinez rounds out this Skeeter lineup. Scott Kazmir has been brutal at the mound this year. No wins, six losses, in the hope that he could return to affiliated baseball. And this is why he came here, to try to work his way back to the affiliated ranks. Former Angel, former Ray, the former Met. And Kazmir was one of the most highly touted prospects in the history of baseball. And he had a 10, 11, 12 win seasons, even some 15 wins scattered in there. And he's had one World Series appearance, believe it or not, with the Tampa Bay Rays. But the left-handed pitcher since that point has gone on a downward spiral with his pitching career, and he's hoping to recover from that. First time that he faced off against the Bluefish was in a start, which was held to just an inning of work, and Brock Peterson took him deep, giving up two runs in that one. The next time that Kazmir faced off against the Bluefish was the first game of this series. He gave up four runs in the first three innings, and Kazmir completed six innings and gave up four runs, but the Bluefish were able to win that game by a score of 4-3 as a result of Dominic Ramos' three-run drive to left center field that closed the gap a little bit for Sugar Land, but the Bluefish were able to hold on behind Juan Rincon's save situation and him shutting the door on the Mosquito Skeeter attack. The left-handed pitcher has a record of 0-6, an ERA of 7.57, and the Bluefish are hoping to inflict the same kind of damage they did to Kazmir in Game 1 in this contest. They have not been able to hit the ball very well this series, just three earned runs over the last 43 innings pitched by Sugar Land. Dates back to it includes the no-out situation in the fourth all the way through to the end of yesterday's game. And the Bluefish, if they're going to score at that rate, they are not going to win many games. Just five total runs during that stretch. Fortunately for the Bluefish, they scored four in the first three innings, which is why they won Game 1. Since then, they have only won one of the other four matchups. The Bluefish and the Skeeters coming up in less than 5 minutes' time. When we come back on the Bluefish broadcast, it's time to throw first pitch from Constellation Field. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller Time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. Ow. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, yeah, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
You know what sounds really great for lunch? Breakfast. And what would be awesome for dinner? Breakfast. See, there's no better choice for breakfast, lunch, or dinner than Chips. Chips Family Restaurants in Orange and Fairfield. Known far and wide for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery, Chips also has a lunch and dinner menu that'll have you ditching the drive-thru and saying bye-bye brown bag. A full lunch and dinner menu of outrageously delicious sandwiches, salads, steaks, reasonably priced. And, of course, Chips' famous pancakes for any meal, any day. For breakfast, lunch, or dinner, flip it to Chips on the Post Road in Orange and in Fairfield at the intersection of Black Rock Turnpike and Tunxas Hill Cutoff. Voted best in Connecticut by the readers of Connecticut Magazine for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery all day long.
A great rendition of the national anthem performed from just in front of the home plate area, and the Bluefish are ready to take on the Sugar Land Skeeters. Scott Kazmir is on the hill for the second time in this set. It's amazing to see how a five-man rotation works, and when a team is able to face one another six times during a particular set, perhaps Kazmir will get acclimated and acquainted with the rest of the Bluefish hitters for another time. Scott Kazmir, his last start was against the Bluefish, six innings of four-run baseball, but he managed to lose his sixth game as a member of the Skeeters, and it has not been a friendly, set of games because his ERA is way up there. The Bluefish hoping that they can get more out of their offense in this contest because they've just been unable to really succeed at any level offensively. Three earned runs scored by the Bluefish in the previous 43 innings of work, and that dates back to the start of the fourth inning when the Bluefish put up a zero in that frame. Joey Gathright's going to lead off. He's followed by Eddie Rogers and Prentice Redmond, 1, 2, and 3. In the order, Kazmir features a fastball, a slider, the curve. He's got the changeup as well, but he's not been terribly effective with each of his pitches, especially against the Bluefish in the first few innings. The Bluefish were able to jump on him early on, scoring two runs in the outset, scoring a run in each of the next few frames. And the Skeeters are ready, as are the Bluefish, for this final game in the regular season at Constellation Field in what has been a gem of a ballpark at Constellation. It is the newest member of the Atlantic League in the Skeeters, and they have showcased their talent throughout. We are underway, 7:07 first pitch, 8:07 on the East Coast. Expected temperatures about 90 degrees, a slight chance of storms, but nothing right now. It should hold off until tomorrow when Tropical Storm Isaac, instead of Hurricane Isaac, moves its way towards the northwest part of Louisiana and may graze with a couple of outlying bands. The next toss is a fastball inside. First one, one ball and no strikes. The Bluefish in their teal uniforms, the Skeeters in their home whites. White bottoms, white tops, the Bluefish in their gray bottoms. The 1-0 from Kazmir, fastball inside, two balls and no strikes. On defense, Steve Moss is in left field. Bubba Bell angles towards left center field. He's the captain of the outfield. Dionis Cesar well away from the right field line, daring Gathright to pull. Next toss is a chopper foul to the right side. Two balls and one strike. Ofelio Castro's at the hot corner. Dominic Ramos is at shortstop. Iggy Suarez is at second base, and Aaron Bates is over at first. Octavio Martinez behind the plate for Scott Kazmir and company. You can tell that there is a live feed, live camera feed from center field with the way that the video's going, and they're trying to make sure that the statistical scoreboard is up rather than the actual video up on the Texas-sized video screen. You could tell by the way that the action's moving, and they're not going to go until that comes out of the picture, and sure enough, it faded to black. You could see it in center field. Two balls and one strike. Jeff Dugmore made sure that that happened. Everyone on the infield playing a little bit up as the pitch is chopped on the ground to the right side, fielding to his right and throwing across to Ziggy Suarez, one away. It is a 4-3 on the putout. Joey Gathright done as Eddie Rogers digs in. That's been a major problem for the Bluefish. Many of the choppers have slowed down in this ballpark, which have not allowed the Bluefish players to get on base. Many of the other parks in the league have fast grass, so if you hit a chopper, it'll speed right through almost the way that AstroTurf would. Not to say that that would not have been made there. It was not as well struck. But Eddie Rogers digs in. The shortstop on the year 270 plus, and now the video board is completely out. The first pitch is a fastball to the outside corner. No balls and one strike. Eddie Rogers has done a tremendous job for the Bluefish on the offensive side with the way that he improved while Shea Hillenbrand was with the ball club. The left-hander weighs in as Rogers waggles the bat. The pitch is slapped foul to the right. No balls and two strikes. I'm sure the video team that's responsible for getting up all the graphics on the Texas-sized video scoreboard is working on that issue at this time. Yesterday, Rogers was 1-for-4. He's at 272. He's driven in 55 runs on the season, which is second among active players on the squad. Number one on the team, Luis Lopez. He still have yet to catch Brock Peterson. The 0-2 swung on and served in towards right center field. Bell, can of corn, two away. It is an F8 for Rogers. He was rounding first, so he's definitely hustling. Problem is, players may be hitting it square, but not quite the way that they hoped. It's one thing to hit it square and land it towards the alley to get an extra base hit. Extra base hits are difficult to come by to begin with. Look how many doubles are hit every year, which is remarkable, considering that Ray Navarrete just set the Atlantic League record. The next toss is outside. One ball and no strikes. Navarrete, more than 40 doubles on the year. The 1-0, fastball outside. Two balls and no strikes. Third baseman, Ofelio Castro, hugging the third base chalk. Everyone else playing straight up. The 2-0. Swung on and driven into deep left center field. On the move, Bubba Bell. He goes towards the track. It's at the wall. That ball is gone. Solo shot. Prentice Redmond. He ripped it to left center field as it careened towards the carousel. The merry-go-round and the Bluefish. Right fielder goes merry-go-round around the bases. It's 1-0 Bridgeport. That was a line drive, a screaming line drive. Home run number 14 on the campaign. You combine that with his 32 doubles, and he is among the league leaders in extra base hits on the season. Top 10 in that category, which is why the Bluefish always put him batting third. He may hit 260, 270 now, but he has an ability to give the Bluefish some quick offense as the first pitch is slapped foul down the right side. No balls and one strike. Already have scored a run in the first inning. That has not happened often for the Fish during this series because the Bluefish have not been able to get too many of their leadoff hitters on. You look at yesterday, it was a 1-2-3. The day before, Gathright gets on, but Rogers does not. Pitches line foul to the right. Otañez is considered a professional hitter. And when Willie Upshaw defines a professional hitter, he says it's a person that always hits line drives. Someone that never takes an at-bat off and is always able to make good contact no matter what. And you can tell by his swing over the last few days that He's just getting more and more acquainted with the pitchers and getting more comfortable. The 0-2 swung on line drive caught to end the inning at short by Dominic Ramos. It was a loopy line drive as it had eyes for left field, but Ramos was able to flag it down. A solo drive by Prentice Redmond accounts for the only hit of the inning. The Bluefish lead 1-0 at the end of a half. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
We believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Are you feeling patriotic, Bluefish fans? Come out and support the team as sparks fly during the fireworks extravaganza weekend, beginning with the first game back from Texas on Friday, August 31st, against the Somerset Patriots. First pitch is at 7:05, and the first 1,000 fans in attendance will receive a tote bag giveaway presented by Universal Sales. Don't miss the skies lighting up for Saturday night against Somerset. The fireworks extravaganza is presented by Cisco Food Distributors. First pitch for Saturday at 5:35. Sunday, all about affordable family fun. All in family fun Sunday with kids autograph sessions and Chet Kids Run the Bases. First pitch is at 2:05. It's a great way to enjoy a family outing while taking in the mild weather at the end of the summer. Tickets are available for the series by going to BridgeportBluefish.com or by calling 203-345-4800. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back. Perry Miles with Gilbert De La Vara is waiting on the hill. He has done a great job for the Bluefish this season with the way that he's been consistently going a minimum of 5 1/3 frames, and he is the innings eater for the road team. He has or will have to deal with the likes of Ofidio Castro, Dominic Ramos, and Dionis Cesar. 1, 2, and 3 in the order for the home team. Gilbert De La Vara, 88-91, occasionally in 92-93. Has a fastball, curveball, and changeup. And the first pitch is on its way. It's a fastball outside, 1-0 and 0 strikes. The third baseman is Brad Boyer. Eddie Rogers is over at shortstop. Luis Figueroa is at second. Luis Lopez is at first. The next toss bends inside. The count, 2-0 and 0 strikes. In left field, it's Joey Gathright. James Simmons occupies center. And the right fielder is Prentice Redmond. De La Vara weighs in. The pitch, another ball. This time high, 3-0 and 0 strikes. De La Vara seems to start out first struggling a little bit to find the command. Then he's able to work his way through the 3-0. Fastball low, 4. 4 straight pitches out of the zone, according to Jeff Dugmore. And Castro walks immediately to first base with Dominic Ramos stepping up.
Shortstop number 4.
The shortstop, 4-for-12 in this series, with 1 homer, 2 ribbies, and 2 strikeouts. He has provided some of the damage. Him and Cesar really have been the players inflicting some of the most damage by the Skeeters, and the Bluefish losing 3 out of the previous 4 games. De La Vara stares at first. The next pitch is a fastball high. That's 5 straight out of the zone to open up his start. 124 innings for De La Vara. He induces the most double plays in the Atlantic League. The next toss is on the outside corner, 1-0 and 1 strike. And it's because he pitches to contact rather than trying to strike everyone out. He understands 88 to 91 is average fastball speed for anybody, righty or lefty. As a lefty, he's able to command the ball with a little bit better speed as the pitch is roped into left field. It heads towards the corner. It's a base hit. Fielding in that corner is Gathright. The throw comes into third. Nice play to hold the runner at second base. A walk and a single for the Skeeters as Castro is at second base. Ramos at first for Dionis Cesar. early on, the Bluefish did not have the same kinds of issues. De La Vara at seven scoreless. And then the eighth inning gave up a three-run home run to Ramos. Three-run home run went to left field. That time, it was a frozen rope to left. And Joey Gathering has plenty of speed to cut it off. This is one of the fastest outfields, if not the fastest outfield in the Atlantic League. With the strides that James Simmons has, Joey Gathright, his ability to fly to the baseball, and also Prentice Redman out in right field has a good amount of speed out there. The next toss is a bunt attempt up the right side. De La Vara bobbles the ball and cannot get it. It's at least going to be a sacrifice. Will it be labeled as a hit? That's the only question, as De La Vara scampered towards the first base line, and there still is no official confirmation. The ball was bobbled. De La Vara, the second baseman Figueroa was covering, believe that's going to be just a sacrifice and an error, probably. Well, one might think. Runners on every base right now. An early rally for the Skeeters against De La Vara. And they rule it as a bunt single. So the bases are loaded for Aaron Bates. This is what Bates was brought in to do. Smack the ball. And it's interesting. Brock Peterson in 2011 came to the Bridgeport Bluefish after Aaron Bates signed with the Rochester baseball club as the pitch is lifted foul. Rochester Red Wings is out of play, 0-1. That happened in 2011. A month later, Peterson joins the Bluefish. Now it seems the tables have turned. Peterson, well, Bates was on the Memphis Redbirds earlier in the year. And now Brock Peterson is the one that's taking Bates' place. Go figure. The carousel continues in the confusion as well. The 0-1 is lifted foul to the right. No balls and two strikes. Bates is a very tall player, but he's not been able to put all of his talent and his approach together to comfortably provide the Skeeters with a good batter in the cleanup spot. They really have no cleanup hitter. Dionis Cesar is the closest one possibly to that. More of a three guy than anything else. It's been a juxtapositioning between Bates, Bell, and Moss. The 0-2 swung on and lifted foul to the right. Count remains at no balls and two strikes. And Dionis Cesar, he's also done some cleanup work. Typically a guy who has great speed with an ability to hit the ball to the gaps is ideal for a three spot. Four spot, don't necessarily need a fast guy, I need a guy to drive in runs. Power, shifting the legs, transfer the weight. Setup is toward the inside, the next pitch, curveball swung on and missed. Bates tried to go deep there, Z, and his eyes lit up, but De La Vara strikes out Bates on what appeared to be a high curveball as Bubba Bell digs in. The infielders on the corners, back up just a hair, Luis Lopez about halfway at first. Meanwhile, the third baseman, Brad Boyer, closing in on the lip of the infield grass. He's further away from the third base bag because of the left-handed batter against De La Vara, the lefty. The next toss is a fastball just off the corner. One ball and no strikes. Curveball would be ideal in a 2-0, especially if he feels comfortable throwing it. The 2-0, swung on and grounded. Base hit to right field. The tying run scores. The go-ahead run's coming to the plate. Prentice Redman's throw is cut up by Luis Lopez, and they have Cesar in the middle of a rundown as Boyer throw eventually catches Eddie Rogers, who applies the tag. The runner who hit the two-run single, and Bubba Bell moves to second on the rundown situation. Castro and Ramos score, and it's 2-1 Skeeters. You fall behind with the bases loaded, two balls and no strikes. You're forced to deliver a pitch towards the middle of the plate. You have to be around the plate, and it's exactly what Bubba Bell knew to do with that baseball. Just deposit into right field as Steve Moss digs in. The left fielder has had his struggles with the Skeeters in 2012. Last night, did not pick up a hit as the next toss is over the inside corner for a strike. He struck out three times. Walked and scored a run. Lefty versus righty, Delavara against Moss. Delavara takes his time. And you can tell that physically, maybe his face showing otherwise, just not showing the same kind of moxie that he normally does. Next pitch is dropped inside. Counted two balls and no strikes. Two runs on three base hits, one run, one base hit. Both teams have scored in the first inning. It's the first time that has happened all series. The 1-0 swung on and missed. Rather, two balls and no strike. Now it's 2-1. Or rather, 1-2. Keep on changing the scoreboard. The next pitch from Delavara is served high in the air to deep right center field. Prentice Redmond moving back. He's toward the track. He makes the play as he guards up against the wall. That ball kept on carrying. The wind is allowing the ball to carry. The Bluefish are out of the inning, but the Skeeters score twice on three base hits. The Bluefish strand one runner. At the end of one, it is 2-1 Skeeters. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. The Bluefish have great gifts and giveaways coming up at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, beginning with a series against the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs on September 11th. Tuesday, September 11th, is Kids Eat Free, presented by Big Y World Class Market. Kids 12 and under are entitled to a hot dog, potato chips, and a fountain beverage. Wednesday is Bark in the Park Night, presented by Canine Company, followed by Thirsty Thursday, presented by Budweiser. Friday the 14th kicks off an appreciation weekend for the fans with a fireworks extravaganza presented by Sabrette. Each of the games during the week begin with a 7:05 first pitch. Saturday the 15th features 2 7-inning games as part of a doubleheader beginning at 1 p.m. from Bridgeport. There is a race pass giveaway sponsored by Grand Prix of New York. Sunday is all about family fun with an autograph session before the game and kids run the bases afterward. A 2:05 first pitch will get you kicked off for the end of the weekend. Tickets are available for these series by going to BridgeportBluefish.com or calling 203-345-4800. Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Bluefish baseball shifts into the top of the second inning. Bridgeport trailing 2-1. It was a solo drive for Prentice Redmond, accounting for the offense in the first inning for the Bluefish. A two-run single to right for Bubba Bell, accounting for the offensive rally from the home team, the Skeeters, as the Bluefish are getting set. Luis Lopez, James Simmons, Luis Figueroa digging in. 5, 6, and 7 in the order. Kazmir unleashes. First pitch is a fastball down the middle. No balls and one strike. Pitches are getting clocked about 85, 86 miles per hour from Kazmir. 35 2/3 innings entering this contest with that bloated ERA. Next toss is outside. One ball and one strike. It's been a consistently bad stretch of games for Kazmir. Even in the last contest, ERA is 6. The 1-1 serve down the right field line, but it is deep and foul. pounded one ball and two strikes. It's very deep down the right field line, especially where the horseshoe is, towards the upper end of the steps. But it's still 348 feet down the right field line. It is almost impossible to hit the home run that way when the wind is fighting it off. The pitch is lifted down the left field line, hustling after the baseball and unable to get there is Ofelio Castro. He nearly did, but could not get to it. He just trapped it down as soon as the ball hit the dirt. Scampered over, tried to go backhand as he sprinted towards the end of the horseshoe on the left. So he went out of sight, and the Bluefish getting ready for more action. You can tell that the light fixtures are going to be turned on shortly. They are getting stronger and stronger as light beams reflect onto the field. Luis Lopez stands in, the left-hander waits and deals, swung on and served, foul to the right. One ball and two strikes. Not too many clouds today. Houston certainly avoided much of the trouble from the tropical system that moved into New Orleans, Mobile, Alabama, Pensacola, Florida, the 1-2, curveball outside, two balls and two strikes. I'm sure many of the games in the Southern League, if they were in New Orleans or wherever, or internationally, that would be one of them. But I'm sure many of the games had to be postponed because of the tropical system moving through. And if Northwest Arkansas and a few others, they may also have to postpone their games tomorrow. The 1-2 is served foul to the right. One ball and two strikes. It's expected to be a foot to 2 feet of rain plus. And when meteorologists talk about foot or 2 feet, it's not your typical measuring of water moving up. The equivalent of 1 inch of rain, about 10 inches of snow. The snow would be a foot, then it would be exactly that on a person. The next toss is lifted foul to the right, a ball and two strikes. There's only so much that Mother Nature can take. In Houston, it's been dry. From what I've heard, just one rain delay, basically 5 minutes as Lopez chases for strike three. He goes down. The first strikeout of the night from Kazmir as James Simmons digs in. Simmons, a 19-game on-base streak heading into tonight's contest. And he has had a number of multiple hit games during that stretch, which has allowed his numbers to excel right to the top. He's one of the active leaders for the Bluefish in batting average, one of the top few in homers, and his RBI total is also getting up there. The one-out pitch is a fastball low, one ball and no strikes. It was buried inside. 7:32 in the state of Texas. The Bluefish will be losing an hour, but have a day off for travel day. The next toss is inside. Two balls and no strikes. They'll have that day off. Come back on Friday, and they will take on the Somerset Patriots, three-game series during the weekend, the 2-0. A fastball traveling low, 3-0. During that Friday, it is tote bag giveaway presented by Universal Sales. Saturday, fireworks extravaganza as the next toss over the inside corner, 3-1. Should be a well-attended event for Labor Day weekend. And that fireworks extravaganza presented by Cisco Food Distributors. 3-1, grounded to third, gobbled up on a couple of shuffles by Castro. The third baseman throws to first and just beats James Simmons to the bag. A 5-3 put out. A couple of steps to the right. So all it took from Ofelio Castro. So clean, so smooth with his shuffling of his feet, the way that his cleats glide each way. And the throw across is icing on the cake. Luis Figueroa digs in. Batting from the right side against the lefty, he's a switch hitter. The two-out pitch is roped into left field. It's a base hit. Sent screaming towards the corner, but Steve Moss plays it in to the shortstop on Brad Boyer digs in. He's at 268 with the Bluefish. His average creeping to around 240. Couple more APs, couple more hits. You may see Boyer come up with a good deal of confidence, maybe start to utilize the power that he's shown during his batting practice sessions. The first pitch is on the outside corner, 0-1. A beautiful night from Sugar Land, Texas. We thank everybody for tuning in to the Bluefish broadcast. The next toss, a curveball over the outside corner for a strike, 0-2. Will Kazmir be able to settle down? If that's the case, the Bluefish may be in trouble. He's the only pitcher that they've really hit this series. 0-2. Chopped on the ground slowly to the right side. Kazmir grabs on the snag and beats Boyer to the bag by a hair. Kazmir bluffed tossing to first to throw to Aaron Bates because he thought there might have been an issue, so he just took it all himself, sprinted over there, and beat him. A single in the frame, but the Bluefish strand that runner. At the end of an inning and a half, 2-1, Skeeters on top. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
To brighten up your home is to do just that. Brighten it up. To illuminate and decorate. The exciting lighting ideas come from Valley Lighting and Home Decor. Your home becomes your showplace when you let it shine with designer lighting so distinctive it is clearly a work of art. Valley Lighting and Home Decor is set to bedazzle you with glittering crystal chandeliers and lamps. Treasures abound in unique home accents, special touches, just the right things to bring your whole decor together. Because home is not just what's inside the four walls. Brighten up your garden, your deck, and your pool area with outdoor landscape lighting. This is the season to invigorate, radiate, celebrate. Rejuvenate. The brightest ideas begin here at Connecticut's largest lighting and home decor showplace. Illuminate and decorate at Valley Lighting and Home Decor on Chestnut Street in Ansonia, just a minute off Route 8, Exit 16.
This is your third season. Are you feeling patriotic, Bluefish fans? Come out and support the team as sparks fly during the fireworks extravaganza weekend, beginning with the first game back from Texas on Friday, August 31st, against the Somerset Patriots. First pitch is at 7:05, when the first 1,000 fans in attendance will receive a tote bag giveaway presented by Universal Sales. Don't miss the skies lighting up for Saturday night against Somerset. The fireworks extravaganza is presented by Cisco Food Distributors. First pitch for Saturday at 5:35. Sunday, all about affordable family fun. All in family fun Sunday with kids autograph sessions and Chet Kids Run the Bases. First pitch is at 2:05. It's a great way to enjoy a family outing while taking in the mild weather at the end of the summer. Tickets are available for the series by going to BridgeportBluefish.com or by calling 203-345-4800. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. The first pitch settled outside. The count, 1-1 and no strikes. It is Manny Mejia, Iggy Suarez, and Octavio Martinez due up. As the seventh hitter in the order takes a strike, 1-1, 1-2. 281 on the year, 3 homers and 20 ribbies. Manny Mejia, a very good hitter. Not much of a defensive presence back there. The next toss, a fastball inside. 2-1. Many individuals suffering throughout the south central portion of the United States today as the next toss is low. Got 3-1. Houston, Texas. Really not impacted by that too much. And Sugar Land to the southwest of Houston. But if you take a look at New Orleans, Baton Rouge, LSU had their football practice canceled for Thursday. The 3-1 is low and inside, 4. Manny Mejia walks. Sets up Iggy Suarez. Plenty of rain, plenty of horrible weather. But it has not impacted this game. It has not impacted much of the Northeast.
just a whole bunch of movement towards the north, and eventually it'll head to the east. May get there by the time the bluefish are on the road in Camden or even Lancaster later in that series. Have to wait and find out, as De La Vara has allowed a second straight leadoff walk many innings. The next toss, curveball over the outside corner for a strike, 0-1. Given up two walks, has surrendered three hits in one plus. De La Vara has to figure a way of mixing and matching what Sugar Land is showing him as the pitch is served to right field. Prentice Redmond hustling towards the chalk, diving and cannot make the play as he had to scoop it up off the dirt. Returning back to the bag, Manny Mejia. No balls and two strikes. This is a beautiful ballpark. 325 down the left field line. 348 to right. There's a little bit of a curvature moving in, left center and right center. It's actually more shallow than the deepest portion of the left and right as the next toss is in there. On and miss, strike three. Nice changeup from De La Vara. As Iggy Suarez is done, Octavio Martinez digs in. Suarez not had much success at all. He was 1-for-3 yesterday, 1-for-9 over the last three games. Really has had just two hits the entire series. Amadeo Zazueta was with the squad on Friday for the first game. He was playing almost every day, but because of his 315 batting average and the fact that he had reached AAA baseball this year, Zazueta was given an opportunity to double-A Toronto as the next toss over the inside corner for a strike, 0-1. Double-A Toronto wanted his services. And it's the same double-A with the likes of the New Hampshire Fisher Cats. Cody Clemens is over there, the 0-1. Curveball blocked in the dirt. One ball and one strike, and essentially bringing the story back to Roger. Clemens pitched on Saturday. It was a great night for the Atlantic League. It was crazy. It was a crazy environment. I'm sure when you think about being at a World Series or being at one of those big time events, maybe a little bit less, but there was a great amount of noise. The pitch is slapped in the right field. It's a base hit. Rounding second and trying for third, Manny Mejia. The throw is not nearly in time. And Mejia goes from first to third with Octavio Martinez serving a single to right. He is a large man, but he's able to motor, uses motor skills, uses speed, tracking around the bags. Ofelio Castro moves in. And with Gaetti's players, they always seem to be able to interpret where necessary advances, where they are not thrown out, and they're wise choices. Test the outfielders, test the infielders. The next toss is fouled off to the right side of the count, no balls and one strike. Bluefish are trailing 2-1 in the bottom of the second frame. De La Vara looks at first, winds and deals, pitch chased. Nice offering from De La Vara to disguise it. Appear to be that diving changeup. No balls and two strikes. Skeeters already have four hits on the day. Lefty versus righty. Castro has walked already. The curveball lands low. One ball and two strikes. Tantalizing pitch. Started out about knee high and then crossed down. Castro saw it all the way. Run scored by Castro and Ramos for the Skeeters. Redmond for the Bluefish. De La Vara is ready. The next pitch, fastball just off the inside corner. Castro spun away, but it was much closer than what he showed. Castro was pretending it was 3 feet inside. That wasn't anywhere close to hitting it. And maybe with that spinorama like a ballet dancer, he's able to sell the call. The 2-2. Line drive past the shortstop, Eddie Rogers, into left center field. It's an RBI single. The ball is bobbled momentarily by Simmons. The throw to second is not in time. It is an RBI single for Ophelio Castro. Both of the runners move up on an error. And the Bluefish are now trailing 3-1. They have to deal with runners at first and second, or rather second and third, as Dominic Ramos digs in. Willie Upshaw quickly heads to the mound. And you can tell De La Vara just was not feeling it. Has not been feeling it today. And he may also feel that he's getting closed out on some of the pitches, but it's not the kind of day that he was hoping for. And there may be bullpen activity early in this contest. The Bluefish will have a day off tomorrow, so it is possible that might throw a Dan Serafini early on, might throw a Jonah Bayless, or even someone else who could possibly have their bullpen today if De La Vara is unable to succeed, and Willie Upshaw trying to make sure that his southpaw does. ...124 innings for the left-hander this year. Just been a bull. But now he's being bullied around. Sharp line drives given up by De La Vara. And he's been hurt by the walks, especially the leadoff walks. Each of the first two innings, leadoff walks have led to runs scoring. Manny Mejia, this frame, Ophelio Castro last inning. It could be worse. The one-out toss, a chopper to the left side foul, and a poor attempt by a fan in the first row to try to lunge at the baseball, and he came nowhere close. In order to catch one of those, you need to have fast reflexes. Be prepared. Same way that the players are when they're staring down the signals, communicating with each other. The 0-1 from De La Vara. Flores trying to establish outside. The pitch is outside, but it's also hot. One ball and one strike. Constellation Field, the final time that the Bluefish will be here. The 1-1 is grounded towards third, flagged down by Boyer. The long throw crosses in time, but it is an RBI 5-3 as Dominic Ramos scores. But a great diving snag by Brad Boyer on the dive to the back. And he got up and used all of his strength to deliver an accurate throw across. Deonis Cesar moves forward. Martinez scores. Castro over to third. Two runs in the first couple of frames for the Skeeters. The infielders have yet to move in. They're going to stay toward the middle, deep. The next toss, curveball outside, one ball and no strikes. The Bluefish, when they've won these games, not necessarily of late, when they've won many of their games, they've been able to score plenty of runs. They're averaging about 7 runs a game. When they're not, it's a different story. Next pitch, foul off. One ball, one strike. It's about 2 or 3 runs a game. The pitching can be great, but you need to score. Objective of the game, outscore the other team. The 1-1 from De La Vara pitches a slow ground ball towards short. Eddie Rogers collects and throws to first for the final out of the frame. But another two-run score. It comes on two base hits, a runner left on. At the end of two, Bridgeport trails 4-1. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and speakeasies. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating the birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark at Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season. Or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great.
We welcome you back. The first pitch is a one-hop line drive towards short, but the throw to first is in plenty of time for out number one. Nice maneuver by Dominic Ramos as Angel Flores goes down on the 6-3 as Joey Gathright digs in. Four earned runs total for the Bluefish in the last 45 innings, now make it 45 and a third. And it's been so basically solo shots or unearned runs for the Fish since that point. It has been a nightmare for the Bluefish to hit with runners in scoring position. They've had a number of opportunities to do so against Jason Lane, against Kelvin Villa, against a few other pitchers, and they just have not gotten the job done. The one out toss, the curveball high, one ball and no strikes. Gathright heading into today at 233 on the year. Left-hander weighs in, the 1-0 swung on and missed. One ball, one strike. Last batter due up in the third inning for the Fish is Eddie Rogers. Spiked the donut on the left side. I don't know what the donut ever did to him. The 1-1. Fastball outside, two balls and one strike. For those unfamiliar with what a baseball donut is, it's used so that way the player can swing the bat with a faster pace at the plate, with more ferocity at the plate. The donut is an additional weight. The 2-1 sent foul to the left off the catcher's mitt of Martinez, 2-2. If you put the donut on, it adds 10, maybe 15 ounces, and you start swinging the bat. And then once you're swinging the 33-30 or the 34-31, whatever bat make and model you have, the weight will allow you to swing less freely and then more freely at the plate once you remove the donut. The next toss is chopped into the dirt, foul. It hit Gathright before he left the batter's box. Or did it? Finding out from Jeff Dugmore. Two balls and two strikes. According to the home plate umpire, it hit Gathright after, or actually before, well, after it hit Gathright before he left the batter's box. That's the indication. So Gathright stands in, lefty-lefty, waiting for the two-ball, two-strike offering. Next pitch.
Three balls and two strikes. Perfect night for baseball. Willie Upshaw would have certainly loved to have played down here, especially in the heat. He loves the heat. The 3-2 is lifted in the air to left field, but it hangs high enough to where Steve Moss can gather it. Two away on the F7 spring Eddie Rogers. Grew up in the state of Texas, out just outside of Houston. And Upshaw loved to not just play baseball. Eventually gained an appreciation for golf. And loves all different sports. And that is the way that his family was able to become as prominent as they did. Willie was a Major League Baseball player for a decade plus. And also a Major League coach for a long time. Nearly became the manager of a ball club. Was a finalist for a couple of opportunities. Of course, there's Gene Upshaw, who unfortunately obviously passed away a few years back, but he was, I believe, the player rep for the NFL in negotiating terms that were appropriate for the players. And think about it this way. He dives to the middle of the plate after it seemed to stay high. Rogers could not believe it. He thought it crossed at his elbow inside or close to it. He was not pleased with the call from Doug Moore. One ball and one strike. Kazmier peers in for the sign again. Next pitch is swung on and lined to the left field, but it hangs high enough. And it's dropped by Steve Moss. Moss dropped the ball as he tried to pick it up with his glove facing the sky and could not come away with it. I believe that's going to be a drop. So Eddie Rogers is in scoring position for the Bluefish. It was a screaming line drive. Could he have it? Could he have had it? Yes. Should he have had it? We don't know yet, and that's an error going to be placed on the board. It is an E7 given to Eddie Rogers as he gets to second base. This drop by Moss. You don't see that often. Moss, a very fast player when he was with the Bluefish, short-handed. One of the most short-handed players. The next toss is low. One ball and no strikes. And there is apparent frustration between Kazmier and the catcher. Now, why is Octavio Martinez circling with Kazmier? Suarez coming over there. Were there words exchanged? Is it an injury? Kazmier has his back turned. Where's that Suarez? That Suarez with his back turned. Kazmier to the left of the mound. I've never seen anything quite like this. They circle around first ball, and it's a whole bunch of infielders, two men out. You never really know what's going on in those meetings. But I guess the middle infielders were trying maybe a different play to relay to keep Eddie Rogers close. With two men out, though, it would not be the wisest choice for Rogers to take off from second base. You never want to commit the first or the third out at third. You better be sure to be safe at third base. There should not even be a throw if the base runner is attempting to steal third. The back is turned as Kazmier brings the glove up towards the belt. Nothing doing from the middle infielders. Next toss is inside, maybe a tad low. Three balls and no strikes. Kazmier waits and delivers. Pitch is outside. Now it's 3-0. The final call was 3-0 on the board. It was only 2-0. Now it's 3-0. Prentice Redmond with a solo shot in the first. The 3-0. Fastball inside, ball four. They were not going to mess around with Prentiss Redmond, but it leads to Willis Otañez, who is easily the best home run hitter on this team. 16 home runs, Mexican League, three more in the postseason in the Mexican League. That's 19 plus the three that he has right now, 22. And he already has three with the Bluefish, seven ribbies. Lefty versus righty. Otañez loves to smack the ball all fields. He has that kind of power. Next pitch swung on and missed. Big cut 0-1. Kazmir got him with an off speed. It is 8 o'clock Central Time. Kazmir and De La Vara. De La Vara has struggled the first couple of innings. Kazmir hoping to get out of his third inning of work unscathed. Nobody warming up in either bullpen. Kazmir waits and fires a fastball away. It's been a nibble fest between Kazmir and De La Vara. De La Vara's trying to plant it on the outside quadrant. He may not be getting the calls, but still trying to go to the outside quadrants of the plate. And just not effective today. The 1-1, a chopper towards third. Flag down, the throw to second is in time. Ofelio Castro, Iggy Suarez, contributors as part of the 5-4, and that ends the threat. Two runners left on base in that frame. No hits, no runs. End of 2.5, the Bluefish are trailing 4-1. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop, perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back on the air. Gilbert De La Vara tossed his final warm-up pitch for the third inning, and he's trailing 4-1 as Aaron Bates, Bubba Bell, and Steve Moss are due up in the order in the third. So many storylines from the Atlantic League as the season winds down. Of course, the Bluefish, after tonight's game, we'll have a projected 25 games remaining. The next toss is low, one ball and no strikes. The Bluefish are going to need to catch up to Southern Maryland. The next series, it would be best if they swept that, because you never know what's going to happen against Lancaster or Somerset or any of those teams, especially pitches low, two balls and no strikes, especially with the way that they're able to pitch. The Bluefish have struggled against Lancaster and Somerset, the best pitching staffs in the league. They have done well against the likes of Camden, Long Island, and some, to a lesser degree, York, as the pitch fired on the outside corner, 2-1. And those teams don't pitch as well. Long Island did win the first half, but as you can tell,
Bluefish took care of business, winning 6 out of 9 games. There's a possibility for a 10th as the pitch is lifted foul to the right, 2 balls and 2 strikes. If the Bluefish are half game down with 1 to play, it could lead to a showdown between the Bluefish and the Ducks for the right to play Southern Maryland in that play-in game for the division title. You came up all alone. Pitch swung on and missed. Strike 3. Bates goes down fishing. Second strikeout for Bates on the day as Bubba Bell digs in.
Now batting your skater, center fielder number 10.
And if somehow Camden were to come from the woodshed and sneak up, or Long Island manages to make an improbable comeback, an improbable run to the division title, then one might argue that there would just be one team from the Liberties. The pitch is grounded over to short, gobbled up by Rogers. The throw to first is in time, 2 away. So Gilbert Delavara may be settling down. First time that he started out with the first 2 batters out, and he had given up leadoff walks, which led to 2 runs scoring. Steve Moss digs in. Moss is 0-for-1. 2.25 heading into the day. Just not the same type of year for Moss. The backdoor breaking ball lands high. 1 ball and no strikes. So many ways that playoff positioning could be determined as Moss sends a high fly to deep right center field. James Simmons back. He's towards the track and makes the catch just in front of the UHV sign at the wall for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish get a 1-2-3 from Delavara. The Bluefish still trailing by a score of 4-1 at the end of 3. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Miller Lite. We know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team with a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, pork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers. A spark from the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with. Sorry, Alan. Drumsticks. Chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. A spark plug. A domino. A house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network with you. We do apologize. There's a little bit of a technical issue, but we got it straightened out. The 0-1 delivery is popped up to the right side, giving chase. Octavio Martinez leans over, and the ball's foul. It was 2 rows back. Martinez could not get there, and it was dropped by one of the fans in the first couple of rows. Had it in his basket. Could not make the catch. Town, no balls and 2 strikes. Beautiful. So we do apologize for the technical difficulties, but we are back on the air. Perry Miles with you. James Simmons digs in. The first pitch to Simmons. Change up inside. One ball and no strikes. Simmons is great opposite field pop, but that one is pulled to the left side and bobbled. It was dropped by Ramos. Simmons' speed may have had something to do with that, but that's easily an E6. Simmons reaches for Luis Figueroa. The Bluefish broadcast will be taking place with the video stream on Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then we'll be taking the video stream down to Lancaster, the Barnstormers, and the Bluefish, and then the River Sharks and the Bluefish. We will see what we're able to accomplish with the video stream there. The one out toss from Kazmir to Figueroa. Curveball drops high, one ball and no strikes. There is no game tomorrow for the Bluefish, but they will have plenty of games down the stretch, which includes a 10-game homestand. They'll have a day off as the pitch is chopped on the ground towards short, flag down, flip to second, one, across in time for the double play. Ramos, Suarez, Bates, 6-4-3, and that ends the inning as the Bluefish do not pick up a hit. They do not score a run as a result of the E6. No runners left on. End of 3.5. The Bluefish are down 4-1. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back. Are you feeling patriotic, Bluefish fans? Come out and support the team as sparks fly during a fireworks extravaganza weekend, beginning with the first game back from Texas on Friday, August 31st, against the Somerset Patriots. First pitch is at 7:05, and the first 1,000 fans in attendance will receive a tote bag giveaway presented by Universal Sales. Don't miss the skies lighting up for Saturday night against Somerset. The fireworks extravaganza is presented by Cisco Food Distributors. First pitch for Saturday at 5:35. Sunday, all about affordable family fun. All in family fun Sunday with kids autograph sessions and Chet Kids Run the Bases. First pitch is at 2:05. It's a great way to enjoy a family outing while taking in the mild weather at the end of the summer. Tickets are available for the series by going to BridgeportBluefish.com or by calling 203-345-4800. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
At Miller Lite, we don't just make a light beer with average taste. We make one with great Pilsner taste. And there's a big difference between great and average. Nobody strives to achieve averageness. Exploring the average outdoors? Have fun in your backyard, Magellan. If that book was called Average Expectations, it wouldn't be worth Dickens. Average minds don't think alike. They don't think, period. Settle for average taste when you can have great Pilsner taste. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you as the Bluefish hang on the Skeeters, and they are trailing 4-1 in this contest. The Bluefish have struggled at this venue to score runs, and that has been a problem for many teams in this league trying to deal with that. The first pitch is inside, and count one ball and no strikes. First batter of the inning, Manny Mejia, followed by Iggy Suarez and Octavio Martinez. Gelber De La Vara awaits the check swing. Did he go? No, says the first base umpire, Eric Dions. Two balls and no strikes. Mejia walked in the second inning to act as a catalyst for the rest of the rally. The 2-0, fastball high, 3-0. And Gelber De La Vara is frustrated with himself. He's left the pitches all over the place. He's not been able to command it as well as what he would hope. And continues to fall down to Mejia, 3-0 in the count. His next toss is on the inside corner, 3-1. Manny Mejia is a big-time power hitter, even though he's only shown a little bit of that with the Skeeters. He's not been playing every day because he does not play defense very well. Pitches lined foul into the seats on one hop. 3 balls and 2 strikes. He's scaled like Spider-Man up the wall. Manny Mejia is able to 3 on the year, but he hit some mammoths last year. Next toss, swung on and served in this deep center field. James Simmons backpedaling and makes the play as he sprinted backwards for out number one. It's an F8, so Mejia is retired to spring Iggy Suarez. And those two innings, the first two innings, may eventually cost Elevara the game. The Bluefish have come back, though, before at this venue from down 4-0. This Skeeters team, though, is much better than the one that the Bluefish were playing toward the end of the first half at this venue. Delavara one time had given up those 4 runs. It was a 4-0 game, eventually became 5-4. Bluefish scored 5 runs combined in the 7th and 8th innings to wiggle through and pick up a victory as the fastball turned loose outside. 1 ball and no strikes. Plenty of media coverage for the Skeeters this weekend. I'm sure it would have been plenty for a major league game as the 1-0 is upstairs, 2 balls and no strikes. Roger Clemens was the hot ticket in town. And no question that it was tremendous impact as the next toss is low. Count 3 balls and no strikes. Delavara fires a fastball down the middle. It's the second time in this inning that he's fallen behind the batter. 3 balls and no strikes. Delavara's 3-1. Sliced in the air to right center field. It drops in for a base hit. Line drive for Suarez. Mejia may not have taken advantage. Suarez did, as the middle infielder did not try to do too much with it. Gets on base with a single. Octavio Martinez digs in. It snaps stretch of 5 consecutive batters retired. Will the motivation coming from Terry McGriff? He jogs out to the mound to talk with Delavara about what just unfolded to inspire some confidence and see what is going on with Dela, because he's fallen behind the count. 3 balls and no strikes. Each of the first two hitters, he was fortunate to get back into the count against Mejia. And against Suarez, it wound up being a hit. If he continues this, he may not be in for that much longer. Falling behind in the count sets a dangerous precedent in any game. If you fall behind in your work, you eventually cannot make it up. If you fall behind in a political race, bank up those percentage points for president. Same way it goes for baseball. You fall behind in the count, it's going to be that much more oppressive to have to work your way through. The one out pitch is a jam shot foul, right side, 0 balls and 1 strike. And if you look at the way that Paul Segura had thrown yesterday, yes, he did give up the 5 runs and the 4 earned. Most of that was toward the latter stages of the game, when it was almost as if he made 1, maybe 2 bad pitches, and that was that. He was in complete command through the first 4 2/3 frames, really. Only difference was as the pitch is grounded over the third, scooped up by Boyer, the flip to second, and then the drop on the transfer. Fielder's choice for Martinez as Octavio is safe. 5-4, Boyer to Figueroa. So Suarez is eliminated. The faster base runner is replaced by the slower base runner in Martinez. But if the Skeeters are fully committed to the running game, they may decide to send Martinez maybe on a hit and run with Castro, knowing that the third baseman has shown keen judgment at the plate with a single and a walk on his resume tonight. Delavara delivers, pitch swung on and missed. Castro tried to end that with a home run to left. He wanted to pull it all the way through. And Boyer understood that as soon as he knew where the location of the pitch was going to be, Boyer drifted toward the third base chalk, make sure that if it was a sharp line drive, he'd be there. Throw to first, not in time. So difficult. So difficult for anyone to imagine how a baseball player prepares and all everything that's associated with it, the strategy. Oh, one timeout is called. Castro leads the current Skeeters club in batting after four players, including Jimmy Van Ostrand, Jason Botts, left the squad. Pitch is blocked in the dirt. It's only a matter of time before the Skeeters may get one or a couple of their players back. Jimmy Van Ostrand, Jason Botts, Miguel Negron. But of course, Katie Johnson probably going to be out for a long time. More permanent injury. The next toss blocked and dirt partially by Flores. Is he able to keep it to his left? And timeout is called. Two balls and one strike. So Negron, Botts, Van Ostrand, they're all gone from the team because they were picked up. And let's not forget about Drew Locke and Ben Harrison, the only ones remaining on the top, Fidel Castro and Bubba Bell. Not too many of the other players are going to be leaving the organization. The pitch is smacked foul to the right off the padding and slips into the first set of seats. Mother Earth stopping the baseball, appears to be the stone stairway heading from the upper part to the lower part, the first row. It's on the right side. Boyer back pedals at third. Still wondering. De La Vara whips it inside and low. Three balls and two strikes. Some deep counts that De La Vara has had to handle today. The 3-2 from De La Vara. Chopped on the ground towards the second base bag. Fielding and throwing on the move, Luis Figueroa for the final out of the frame. The slow chopper to the right side was handled by the second baseman. The Bluefish are out of the inning. End of four. After one runner had been stranded, one base hit, the Bluefish are trailing 4-1. Stay tuned. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Collins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Just being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team, including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie. Open 7 days a week. Stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the major league experience.
This is Paul Segura, and you're listening to Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team?
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you as the first pitch is poured in for a strike to Brad Boyer. He's followed by Angel Flores and Joey Gathright. 8-9-1. Kazmir delivers. The next pitch is a curveball to the middle of the plate. 0-2. Boyer tonight is 0-4-1. Suffered a ground ball. As next pitch is a chopper towards short, angling forward and throwing on the move to just beat Boyer, Dominic Ramos for out number one. The Bluefish have come back before from three-run deficits before. They've come back number of times for victories this season. And they're going to need to string some hits together and hit with runners in scoring position. Those are the two big parts. Those are the two big pieces. Sugar Land's pitching has been unquestionably good, with the exception of Kazmir. Even tonight, Kazmir is seeming to get back on track. And maybe the first win will catapult his confidence. The next toss sinks to the inside corner, 0-1. Nice curveball today from Kazmir. Flores 0-1 with a 6-3 as the next pitch is popped up to the right side. Octavio Martinez scampers after it, has room and makes the play. Two out on the PF2. Angel Flores goes down, former Lancaster Barnstormer. Played AAA for a little bit. Actually competed Major League training camp for a while. Joey Gathright's been to plenty of Major League Baseball spring training camps. The Bluefish left-handed pitcher has done, the left-handed batter did a great job with Louisville this year, but was not promoted and was released, matter of fact. Had he stolen a few more bases, had he been part of another, as the timeout is called, as the video screen came up. Video screen came up with showing the way that the pitch tilted. So it can be distracting to watch yourself in a mirror. That is quite interesting. The next toss is a fastball to the inside corner after the first one was a curveball dropping outside. Kazmir asked, why did you stop? Gathright pointed the video board, and I'm sure Kazmir is aware of that. It is an interesting moment when the video accidentally props up. The 0-1 is a 30-footer. That was a cricket strike. And not much Octavio Martinez could do. I'm being fair. It was a spike job. Gathright at 4-3. Fly ball to left on his resume tonight. The 1-1. Slips outside, 2-1. Gathright has the ability to pull the ball, but the outfielders are angling him more towards the opposite field. If he's able to hit to right field, he'll go for a triple. Next toss, a fastball to the corner. 2 balls and 2 strikes. And many of the players in the Atlantic League likes a Gathright. One time, they were great. They were fantastic players, and no disputing that. But many of them understand where they're at in their career. Gathright hoping to get back the same way that he did in 11. Atlantic League, then NABL, as the next toss is over the outside corner for a called strike three, and there goes Gathright. He is frustrated with the strike zone from Jeff Dugmore, and Gathright continues to yap with Dugmore. We will see if there's any action continuing as
He is walking towards the third base side and is outwardly adamant about the way that he felt about the previous calls. The Bluefish trail 4-1 at the end of 4.5. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Life wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite Taste Points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5/1/12 and ends 8/1/12. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk
nice
during your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should,
yeah,
it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Gilbert De La Mara is on the hill for the Bluefish as the Skeeters come to the plate in the bottom of the fifth inning. Bridgeport trailing by a score of 4-1. They have had all kinds of problems scoring runs in Skeeter country. They're hoping to change their fortunes. This is the final four frames. They've certainly been able to come back before against the Skeeters. De La Mara holding zone over the last couple of frames. Maybe he can put up another zero in the fifth. As the first batter of the frame is Dominic Ramos. He is followed by Dionis Cesar as the pitch is fouled off to the right, 0-1. And then Aaron Bates, 2, 3, and 4. Bluefish have a lot of work needs to be done. The next toss is on its way from the southpaw. De La Vara deals, and the next fastball is low. Count 1-1. The Bluefish have done a good job pitching, especially against the Skeeters in this series. Curveball sent to the inside corner. 1-2. Yes, the Skeeters did score 5 runs last game. And it just so happened that the game before that was against Matt Pike. And they scored 3 runs against Matt Pike and another 2 against Jesse English. It's a total of 5. So 10 over the last couple of games, which will certainly win you ball games if an offense is struggling. Before that, it was pretty good as the next toss is partially blocked in the dirt. 1-2. And some of those were unearned runs. So it's not as if the pitching's doing all the wrong things. Sometimes defensively, there are some miscues. Other times, Sugar Land is plugging the holes. The way that much of this works. Next pitch, swung on and missed, strike 3. 1 away as Ramos goes down and Dionis Cesar moves in. It was heat. Cesar 1-2. Get to the Atlantic League scoreboard update momentarily. De La Vara about to spring to the mound again. Third base side of the rubber. Lifts his leg, winds, and fires. Another chopper to the left side, this time foul. No balls and 1 strike. Lancaster 11 and Somerset 3 in the bottom of the seventh inning. The Barnstormers continue to bash the Patriots. The Revolution leading the Bluecrafts 4-1. If the Bluefish are able to get this victory tonight, as another slow roller is angled by the shortstop Rogers. He throws to first in time for out number two. 6-3 as Rogers sprinted in towards the lip of the infield grass, was able to get it. He's not committed too many errors down here. We have not seen Rogers boot the ball, but he had more than 20 errors on the year entering this series. He covers so much ground, but at the same time, he has committed those physical miscues. But with Boyer there, a little bit more range over at third base. Lopez at one time had great range defensively, which is why he was able to propel the through the ranks the way that he did. The fastball outside, the count 1-0. At this age, at times he can show that range, but Brad Boyer can easily make up so much more ground, and Rogers does not have to cover as much real estate as the pitch is lifted in the air to shallow right. Prentice Redmond dives and cannot come up with the baseball. He slid, got a piece of the glove, it slipped by, but he was able to recover it before Bates could move any further. That is the first hit of the night for Aaron Bates as Bubba Bell sticks in. Long Island leads Camden 3-2 in the top of the eighth inning. And taking a quick look at Lancaster's scoring line, they're leading the league in scoring. J.D. Durbin, 6 2/3 innings of three-run baseball. This taking place in Somerset. 4 RBI for Galen, 2 for Lentini and Harvey. 3 RBI for Horlbeck, and that is it. Chase Wright got righted out of town. Next toss over the outside corner, 0-1. Kibler was nibbled all the way through, 3 1/3, 2 runs on 4 hits, so Kibler did not perform well. Carlton Smith has thrown scoreless baseball. J.D. Durbin still on the hill, and the bases are loaded for Somerset. Or is it Somerset? Yes, Somerset. Conversation at the mound ends quickly as Flores goes back. York 4 and Southern Maryland 1. That taking place, at least as far as we know, in the bottom of the eighth inning. And Southern Maryland has scored its only run, I believe, on a Kevin Rios homer. Next toss, slap foul, left side. No balls and 2 strikes. 2 ribbies for Joe Thurston. An RBI for Castro and Fiorentino. Rios with an RBI and a run. Vasquez did not have his best performance today. 7 innings, 4 runs, 10 hits, 1 walk, 3 strikeouts. Baseball, Chris Cody. 7 innings, 1 run, 6 hits, 1 walk, 2 strikeouts. Pitches ground to the right side. Figueroa collects and throws to first in time to retire the side. And the Bluefish have done a solid job defensively and pitching the ball each of the last 3 frames, not allowing a run, but the Bridgeport squad still trails by 3. It's 4-1 at the end of 5. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love, baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Meet Ice Cube.
What's up?
Ice Cube is cold.
No, the coldest.
But one thing just might be colder.
Man, it better not be.
Coors Light has a new 2-stage cold-activated label that not only tells you when your beer is cold, but super cold.
Yeah, I know. Super cold. It threw snow on me last time.
It snowed on you?
You better check yourself.
Ice Cube is cold, but Coors Light is super cold. Frostbrewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Bluefish baseball is back for inning number 6. Bridgeport trailing 4-1 in the contest. And they are still aiming to try to come back in this game. Scott Kazmir so far has shut him down. 5 innings of one-run baseball. Still plenty of game to be played. As the first pitch is on its way from the southpaw, Kazmir floats inside. The count, 1-0. 2 hits on the night for the Bluefish, 1 walk. And 1 base runner reached on an error. The next toss is inside. 2-0. Prentice Redmond homered and walked. Luis Figueroa singled, and Eddie Rogers reached on an error. There have been actually 2 Skeeters errors today. Next pitch is sent high in the air to left center field, backpedaling the shortstop Dominic Ramos. He's called up by Bubba Bell, who sprints in to make the catch for out number 1. It's an F8 for Redmond as Willis Otañez digs in. We're also going to take a quick look at the ESPN scoreboard update, especially in Big League Baseball. Has been quite a run for the wild card. The Yankees lose another series as the next toss is outside. Count 1-0. Yankees lose the finale of the series by a score of 8-5 to Toronto. The next pitch is grounded to third, gobbled up at the hot corner by Castro, rings it across, 2 away. A 5-3 for Willis Otañez. Or rather, Prentice Redmond. And now it brings up Willis Otañez. The Bluefish hoping to avoid another 1-2-3 inning. They've already had 1-1-2-3 inning, and they've been retired in order each of the last 2 frames. They're hoping to avoid that same fate this inning as the next toss is low. 1-0. In the Yankees' loss today, 8-5, CeCe Sabathia moved to 13-4, and the Yankees' 20 games over. And Otañez takes a big swing and nubs it at the plate. Count at 1-1. Sabathia goes 7 innings, gives him 5 runs, only 2 earned on 9 hits and 8 strikeouts. J.A. Happ, 5 innings, 4 run baseball, but he wins the game. Doesn't matter how many earned runs you give up, you have a whole bunch of other runs, it can be a problem. And then Jansen with his 17th save, Brandon Lyon and Loop with holds. Not too many people worry about the holds too often as the pitch is outside. 2-1. Although middle relief pitching has to be one of the more thankless jobs other than being a spot starter, because you can either earn a hold or you can blow a save. The next pitch is sent foul to the right. 2-2. Or you could win, or you could lose. The middle relief role has become increasingly important in Major League Baseball, and also in the affiliated ranks. Not necessarily. It is important to hold the lead. Don't get me wrong. But many of the pitchers in these organizations, they've been closers at times, and now have to resort to other roles. As the 2-2 winds outside, 3-2. They have to resort to, rather be
being the closer, they have to resort to being a setup man or even one of the guys early on, like Jonah Bayless. Bayless has even been transformed into a starter and a long guy. Pitch is grounded towards short, gobbling up on three hops and throwing to first, Dominic Ramos for the final out of the frame. A 6-3, the Bluefish are retired in order for the third straight inning and a second straight 1-2-3 without any base runners reaching. The Bluefish are trailing 4-1 at the end of 5.5. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training, rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week. Stop in and meet our team or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
Bluefish Baseball is back on the air. Perry Miles with you. Steve Moss is at the dish for the Skeeters. And the offense for the Skeeters has been much better over the last few games than it has been for the Bluefish. The next toss is over the outside corner for a called strike. No balls, one strike. Beautiful night at the ballpark. Just not quite the result so far for the Bluefish. The pitch is sent high in the air to shallow center. James Simmons sprints forward and makes the catch on the run. One out to open up the bottom of the sixth inning. We are going to have the rest of the Major League scores during the post-game show. We're also going to present some of the Major League scores in the seventh. Update you with a little bit of Atlantic League as well. Some men's and women's tennis from the final tennis major of the year. So after the F8 to Moss, it sets up Manny Mejia, and he lets it go as Gilbert guides it over the outside corner, 0-1. A lefty-righty situation with Manny Mejia standing in. The pitch is chopped over the hill. The shortstop, Rogers, collects and fires and beats Mejia by a stride. Two out. A 6-3 on the put-away as Iggy Suarez trying to add something to the party. So far today, Suarez basically brought the equivalent of some chocolates, if you will. Ever bring a chocolate to a regular event? Maybe a Hershey's Kiss or a whole bag of chocolates with Mr. Goobar or Hershey Kisses? Well, Suarez done that. A single, nothing too fancy. All the fancy stuff came from Bubba Bell earlier as the next toss outside, 1-0. Right about now I could use some chocolate, chocolate chip cookie, maybe even ice cream. The 1-0 is low, two balls and no strikes. Make myself hungry. Gilbert Delavara hungry to strike out some batters, and he's also aiming for another
Breeze. The pitch is grounded over towards third. Boyer fields and flips in time to retire the side. So an excellent recovery by Gilbert De La Vara. He has had 2 1-2-3s, and he has only given up 2 hits in the last 4 innings. So the Bluefish, they're pretty happy with his outing so far. Even though he did give up the runs early, Bridgeport not happy with the result right now, though. It is 4-1, Sugar Land on top. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week, so I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store, but stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I used to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with KU.org.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and sweet leases. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating the birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home games of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark in Harbor Yard during the 15th anniversary season. Or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back. We are in the top of the seventh inning, and the Bluefish are down by a score of 4-1. Luis Lopez, 0-2 with a couple of strikeouts. And this series, he has not had too much success as the next toss is on the outside corner, 0-1. His season has been a seesaw. 3-20 so far. 3-22, and spot fires one away. 6-3 on the put out for Lopez. He's 3-23 in this series, and you can tell by the offensive numbers, it's not quite the same as James Simmons digs in. Simmons headed into today at 280 and a 19 game on base streak. He would either need to walk or collect a hit as Kazmir deals in the curveball delivered outside. 1-0 and no strikes. Simmons did not play yesterday after coming up with 2 walks and a single. As the next pitch is grounded towards short, scooped up by Ramos. The throw to first is in time as the shin guard popped out from Simmons. And Dan Lassard, the bus driver for the Bluefish on the East Coast, and does not drive the bus out here. It's handled by the Skeeters out here. Dan Lassard went after the shin guard, gave it to James Simmons, who's jogging out there. And with two away on another ground ball, 6-3, it sends Luis Figueroa to the dish. Just 2 hits tonight for the Bluefish. All kinds of frustration at this point. The curveball lands outside, 1-0 and no strikes, and there is bullpen activity for the Skeeters. A couple of people stretching themselves out, a little bit of a whirl of dervish as the next toss is a jam shot sent towards left field, a broken bat that's sent right to the glove of Steve Moss for the final out of the frame. It is an F7, a 1-2-3 inning for Kazmir as he has retired the last 10 batters that have come to the plate. The Bluefish trailing 4-1, seventh inning stretch time. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at bridgeportbluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop. Perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
You know what sounds really great?
Bluefish baseball returns. Scott Kazmir has thrown his best game of the season by far. And he had an ERA coming into the day of 7.5 plus. And he right now, his team is winning 4-1 with Gilbert Delavara hoping to get through the seventh inning. First couple of frames may be the undoing of the Bluefish. Have to wait and find out. The offense can still come back. They have done that in the late innings. Going to be much more difficult with the likes of Saul Rivera and Majeski as the pitch is grounded to first. Lopez fields and throws to first with a little bit of a stutter step, and Gilbert cannot step on the bag. He slipped with his cleat, and I believe that's going to be an error on Gilbert. It was a perfect throw by Lopez. And Octavio Martinez beats it out. They could rule it as a base hit. I would highly doubt that, though. Ophelio Castro digs in. Martinez at first. Gilbert Delavara stares in. Scott Kazmir at 82 pitches, the last time that he won a game, September 19th of 2010. And he did it against the Rays. Pitch is grounded. Base hit down the left field line. As it heads towards the corner, Martinez around second and heads for third. It is a double as the ball is thrown in from the corner. And the Bluefish are in trouble. There are runners at second and third with nobody out after the Castro double. So Gilbert Delavara in a bit of a problematic situation. And Willie Upshaw indicating to Terry McGrift to get someone warmed up with several hand signals to the bullpen. And it might have been a righty in the bullpen that's going to warm up. We'll have to wait and find out. It's very Dominic Ramos digs in. He already has an RBI on a grounder. He has a single and a run scored. He has a strikeout, so he's 1-4-3 tonight. Southpaw releases first pitch, ground ball to third, and it's bobbled by Boyer. Keeps it himself, and the bases are loaded. It is an error, probably on Boyer. Should have had it. And Willie Upshaw heads to the mound. That's two errors in the inning already for the Bluefish. I believe the first one was Gilbert Delavara on his failure to catch the ball, and the second one was an E5 to Dominic Ramos. Boyer knew he should have had it. The bases are loaded, nobody out for Dionis Cesar. This could open up the game even more. There's still a shot to get the runner at home. The runners will not go on contact unless the ball hits the ground. If the ball hits the ground, then the runners have to move in order to try to score the run. And they would have to move because they're being forced by everyone else in motion. It's a science, all right. Round the bases, ground ball to the mound, and runner must come home no matter what. And I'm sure De La Vara is going to come home first rather than go towards second, and the infielders are in, especially towards the corners. The middle infielders halfway. They hope to turn a double play, and the outfielder is playing very deep, except for Prentice Redmond and Wright. Next toss, curveball, broken bat, looper to the right side. The second baseman, Figueroa, makes the catch. Infield fly rule in effect for out number one. A broken bat jam shot by Dionis Cesar. It is a P4 as Aaron Bates digs in, and Willie Upshaw makes his way to the mound. De La Vara seemed to be working his way through. Any other runs that he was to give up now would be unearned because of that jam shot. Two errors on the play, one his own undoing, but the second one was by Brad Boyer. And right now, the Bluefish could be out of the inning, but instead, De La Vara is. This call to the bullpen, Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for our community. When we come back on the Bluefish Broadcast Network, the bases are loaded in the bottom of the seventh. Bridgeport trails 4-1. We'll be back right after this.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Bluefish baseball is back. Perry Miles with you. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. It's Julio DePaula on the hill for Bridgeport. The right-handed pitcher has done a tremendous job this year. Of late, he has struggled a bit. Fastball slider will have that breaking pinnings of four and run baseball. That will not change the number of earned runs that he's allowed. The number of total runs could change because the Bluefish should be out of this inning by that point. If DePaula induces a double play or if DePaula strikes out Bates and retires Bell or some combination of the two to where he can eliminate the Skeeters without allowing another run across, that'd be a great sign for the Bluefish moving forward to the top of the eighth in the hopes that they'll be able to score some runs. All it really would take is one big hit with runners in scoring position. Get the job done. Bates stands in, waggles the bat a little bit before works his way to the top. Slightly open sand setup is toward the outside corner. The next pitch, check swing, went through. No balls and one strike. Tried to check the swing. Today, one hit, one run, one ribby for Redmond, one hit for Figueroa, one walk for Redmond. The only base runners for the Bluefish. Plenty of them for the Skeeters. Next toss lifted foul to the right. No balls and two strikes. Two hits a run in Ribby for Castro, hitting a run with a Ribby for Ramos. Cesar, Bates, each with one hit. Bell with a hit and two Ribbies. A run for Mejia, a hit for Suarez. Martinez, one hit and one run so far in Kazmir. Seven innings, two hits, a run, a walk, and three strikeouts. No balls and two strikes with one man out. Paul Adeel swung on a miss. Strike three. Got him on a heat. Nice pitch by DePaula. Set him up inside, filtered it outside, was able to mix speeds, locations, and differentiate them from different quadrants of the plate. Got to the inside, moved to the outside, got him. Bubba Bell takes in. It's not as if Sugar Land's offense has been this juggernaut the way that Lancaster's it might be, or York, Long Island at times. As the next pitch is grounded foul to the right, no balls and one strike. They've stranded their fair share of base runners, and they are among the worst offensive teams in the league, Sugar Land. 1 point, it's going 6-10. Having scored 37 runs in those games. The next pitch, fastball outside. One ball and one strike. Skeeter mascot making his way around and entertaining the fans. As a matter of fact, he's maybe settling right in front of the camera at this point before he moved out. One ball and one strike. DePaula peers in for the side and receives. Glove held high at the shoulder. Next toss, a fastball low. It was also outside, two balls and one strike. Bubba Bell has very good defensive instincts. And he's a very good contact hitter. Not exactly what translates to affiliated ranks, though. Not quite the same kind of speed at the big league level, and scouts try to project those numbers. The pitch is lifted in the air, projected in the air to left field. Charging forward to make the catch is Joey Gathright for the final out of the frame. The bases were loaded with nobody out, and the Bluefish hold down the Skeeters to no runs. Will that propel them? Find out. It's the top of the eighth inning coming up. The Bluefish trailing 4-1. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Come and join the Bluefish for a playoff push in 2012. The Bluefish have great options from picnics and birthday parties to harbor club outings and speakeasies. Invite your friends, family, or coworkers out to the ballpark for an exciting night of affordable family fun. Kids celebrating a birthday party at the ballpark will get an autographed baseball, a visit from BB the Bluefish, and much, much more, including a chance to compete in the best on-field promotions Connecticut has to offer. Don't miss out on the final home game of the regular season. Book your outing with the Bluefish today. Call 203-345-4800 to schedule an unforgettable day at the ballpark and on the yard during the 15th anniversary season. Or go to BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
The best way to brighten up your home is to do just that.
Brighten it up. To illuminate and decorate. The exciting lighting ideas come from Valley Lighting and Home Decor. Your home becomes your showplace when you let it shine with designer lighting so distinctive it is clearly a work of art. Valley Lighting and Home Decor is set to bedazzle you with glittering crystal chandeliers and lamps. Treasures abound in unique home accents, special touches, just the right things to bring your whole decor together. Because your home is not just what's inside the four walls, brighten up your garden, your deck, and your pool area with outdoor landscape lighting. This is the season to invigorate, radiate, celebrate, rejuvenate. The brightest ideas begin here at Connecticut's largest lighting and home decor showplace. Illuminate and decorate at Valley Lighting and Home Decor on Chestnut Street in Ansonia, just a minute off Route 8, Exit 16.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles with you. Score is 4-1. And the Bluefish are hoping that they can get a rally going against Scott Kazmir. There is there are a plethora of pitchers down the right field line that are up, standing, and getting ready to warm up for the Skeeters as Brad Boyer digs in, followed by Angel Flores and Joey Gathright. It is possible that Gathright would be the final hitter that Kazmir faces all night, because two of the next three are lefties. The fastball's on the inside corner for a strike. No balls and one strike. Gary Gaetti does not believe in the whole lefty-righty philosophy switch. If you have a player that is able to retire both lefties and righties, why not go with that guy? And Kazmir's been awesome tonight. The next toss is outside. One ball and one strike. He's been splendid. The Bluefish have not had much of a chance. The only run scored tonight on a Prentice Redmond home run. The left-hander weighs in. The 1-1 curveball swung on and hit in the air to left, right center field. Charging forward to make the catch. Deonna Cesar, that was a sinking, lunging line drive. Stayed high enough to where Cesar could flag it down. It is an F9 on the score sheet as Angel Flores steps up. He is 0-4-2 today. Two hits and a walk. And James Simmons on the verge of having his on-base streak snapped as the first pitch is outside. One ball and no strike. Next toss, a curveball over the outside corner for a strike. One ball and one strike. His curveball's been working, the fastball, all of his pitches, manipulation through the zone. The 1-1 swung on and missed. Could not hold up, a ball and two strikes. And when Kazmir was great in the big leagues, not only was he utilizing these array of off-speed pitches, but his fastball got into the mid-90s, 95, 96. The 1-2 swung on and sent high in the air towards right center field, but Bubba Bell makes the catch, sliding to a shoulder. He did the stomach slide instead of the foot first slide. Was able to come away with the baseball on the F8 as it sends Joey Gathright to the dish with two men out. Scott Kazmir has been economical with his pitches. By the way, that was pitch number 89 on the night, 50 for strikes. What more do you want from Kazmir? Throw strikes, effectively neutralizing the Bluefish bats without allowing them to extend. The only blemish on his resume really is the Redmond home run. Yes, he had two hits. The pitch yanked outside. One ball and no strikes. Kazmir just, he grabs the ball and guess what? The pitchers at times. It's almost like a pyramid with the Bluefish on the board. Next toss is a floater outside. Two balls and no strikes. A run, two base hits, and three errors. If there was weight on top instead of the weight on the bottom with the errors, Bluefish would be in this a little bit closer. It's one run instead of three as Gathright sends a high pop behind the plate. Octavio Martinez has room and makes the play on the warning track for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish continue to struggle as Gathright is 0-4-4. Another 1-2-3 inning, 3-6. No, that is 14 straight batters retired by Scott Kazmir as the Bluefish are now trailing by a score of 4-1 heading into the bottom of the eighth. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Are you feeling patriotic, Bluefish fans? Come out and support the team as sparks fly during the fireworks extravaganza weekend, beginning with the first game back from Texas on Friday, August 31st, against the Somerset Patriots. First pitch is 7:05, and the first 1,000 fans in attendance will receive a tote bag giveaway presented by Universal Sales. Don't miss the skies lighting up for Saturday night against Somerset. The fireworks extravaganza is presented by Food Distributors. First pitch for Saturday at 5:35. Sunday, all about affordable family fun. All in family fun Sunday with kids autograph sessions, and Chet Kids Run the Bases. First pitch is at 2:05. It's a great way to enjoy a family outing while taking in the mild weather at the end of the summer. Tickets are available for the series by going to BridgeportBluefish.com or by calling 203-345-4800. Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball. Get hooked.
You know what sounds really great for lunch? Breakfast. And what would be awesome for dinner? Breakfast. See, there's no better choice for breakfast, lunch, or dinner than Chips. Chips Family Restaurants in Orange and Fairfield. Known far and wide for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery, Chips also has a lunch and dinner menu that'll have you ditching the drive-thru and saying bye-bye brown bag. A full lunch and dinner menu of outrageously delicious sandwiches, salads, steaks, reasonably priced. And, of course, Chips' famous pancakes for any meal, any day. For breakfast, lunch, or dinner, flip it to Chips on the Post Road in Orange and in Fairfield at the intersection of Black Rock Turnpike and Tunxas Hill Cutoff. Voted best in Connecticut by the readers of Connecticut Magazine for extreme acts of outrageous pancakery all day long.
Welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you as Steve Moss takes the first pitch inside. One ball and no strikes. Gilbert De La Vara had settled down. Two errors resulted in the bases loaded. DePaula came in after De La Vara recorded the first out. DePaula was able to shut down the next two hitters. One on a strikeout, the other one on a fly ball to left. DePaula weighs in. Moss lifts his bat. The next toss, a fastball to the edge. One ball and one strike. Let's take a quick look at the scoreboard update courtesy of ESPN.com. As the next pitch is a backdoor breaking ball, maybe backdoor slider. Count two balls and one strike. Azarenka, number one seed for the women's side. Sharapova, Kvitova, Stosur, and Lina, all that move on along with Marion Bartoli. And in men's tennis, as the next pitch just missed off the corner, three balls and a strike. Andy Murray leading unranked Dodig 2-0. And 1-0 in set three. Ferrer, Del Potro, Tipsarevic, Isner all moving on. Next pitch, a backdoor breaking ball inside corner strike. 3-2. That's your tennis. The Yankees lost 8-5. The Mets defeat the Phillies 3-2. Angels and Red Sox scoreless in the top of the first. The 3-2 is a high drive to left, but playable for Joey Gathright as he side shuffles to his left and makes the play, veering towards left center for the first out of the eighth. It's an F7 for Moss. Manny Mejia digs in. Manny Mejia, a walk, a fly ball to center, and a ground ball to short. It has been that kind of day for the Bluefish. They have done everything that they could. They tried to come back. A couple of base runners on as the next toss is low, one ball and a strike. A couple of base runners on in the third inning. But since that point, they have not had a single base runner. It's just been that kind of incredible game for Kazmir as the next toss swerves outside. Two balls and no strikes. Sometimes better pitching, no matter how good your offense might be or how prolific it might be from time to time, a good pitcher will be able to shut it down. And Kazmir tonight may have found something that works. Fastball outside. Three balls and no strikes. That's the case. Even if the Skeeters don't make it to the postseason, it's still going to be a positive because Kazmir will find his way back and maybe make a comeback toward the big league level next year as the next toss is sent foul to the left, 3 balls and 1 strike. Kazmir had been miserable the first 6 games with ERA as high as it was and may have started getting better and better each time. Bluefish offense right now just trying to score many runs. That pitch is smacked deep left field. No chance. That ball is gone. Solo drive, Manny Mejia, his 4th of the season, his 21st RBI of the campaign, and the Skeeters now with a 5-1 lead. Left it over the middle of the plate, and Mejia mashed it. As DePaula left the breaking ball toward the middle. No doubt about that one. That went out to the canopy of the Performance Mazda Picnic Plaza. Iggy Suarez moves in another 5 spot today for the Skeeters. And that is the key. Score enough runs to be able to shoot themselves to victory. It's almost like when they use one of those shooters to fling the shirts into the crowd. The fans are excited about that. First pitch is a fastball to the outside corner, 0-1. And that Mejia shot was right over. Flash of energy, flash of adrenaline. The 0-1 blocked in the dirt. 1 ball, 1 strike. The right-hander deals the 1-1, floats outside, 2 balls and 1 strike. DePaula waits. He delivers again. The next toss is outside, 3-1. And that has been DePaula's problem. Gives up plenty. He gives up his fair share of home runs. Whenever he gets hit hard. Of course, on most of the other pitches that he allowed those home runs, it was not on a breaking ball that much toward the middle, mostly fastballs. A 3-1 is decked to deep left center field. On the move, James Simmons. So is Joey Gathright, and that ball is gone. Solo shot for Iggy Suarez. Back-to-back, given up by DePaula. And the Bluefish are now trailing by a score of 6-1. Wow. That pitch was crushed. Iggy Suarez comes up with it. Octavio Martinez digs in. Next toss is over the outside corner for a strike. 0 balls and 1 strike. Right-hander weighs in for the signal, gets it. The next pitch is a jam shot sent towards third. Cue is foul, 0 balls and 2 strikes. Will Kazmir finish the game? Or will it be another member of the bullpen? Because Kazmir did such a wonderful job. Gave up a solo shot in the first. 2 hits. Tonight for the Bluefish. One by Redmond, one by Figueroa. Redmond was the only other one to get on base. Next toss, slider away. 1 ball and 2 strikes. 9:25 Central Time from Constellation Field. As DePaula dealing the pitcher's line right to third, scooped up on one hop by Boyer, the throw to first is in time, scooped up by Lopez. Two-way. So no back-to-back-to-back home runs. Now batting here, Skeeters, third baseman number 11, Leo Sane, Ophelio Castro. Ophelio Castro moves forward. He's reached base three times. Next toss is delayed for a moment as DePaula steps off. The next toss inside on a fastball, one ball, no strikes. 6-1 ball game in the bottom of the eighth. Luis Lopez about halfway between the lip of the infield and outfield grasses. The 1-0. Slider outside, two balls and no strikes. The Bluefish are certainly going to have to evaluate matters after the way that they've unfolded tonight. Still have a shot. One more. They have three outs. Score at least five runs. They've scored five runs in an inning before this. Obviously, the next pitch is slap foul, right side. Two balls and a strike. It is 14-4. Lancaster on top of Somerset in the bottom of the ninth. The York Revolution closed out the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. Next pitch, fastball inside. Three balls and a strike, and the Bluefish, if they lose a game below the 500 mark, absolutely pasted. The 3-1. Fastball away, ball four. Ophelio Castro has reached base four times tonight. Willie Upshaw making his way to the mound. He'd like to end this as quickly as possible because he wants his bats to get another chance up there. Willie Upshaw, slow visit to the mound. Maybe talking about location and of the offerings. And Castro has reached base four times on the night. There have been singles by Dominic Ramos, Cesar, Aaron Bates, Bubba Bell. Manny Mejia has reached twice, as has Suarez. That's it. But it's been the timeliness of the hitting. Two very good starters, Delavar and Osigueras. Sugar Land seem to sweeten up their end of the deal by taking care of Osigueras towards the latter stages of that contest. And this game, they attacked Gilbert early, sensing that the Bluefish left-hander was getting behind in counts to a degree. And followed by throwing below average pitches once he fell behind in the count. And that's gives credit to the Skeeters hitters for working the counts the way that they did. The Bluefish at one point this season definitely hadn't been doing that. And they're doing their best to try to get back to that form. The next toss is inside, one ball and no strikes. Sometimes there's not much more that you can do other than tip your cap to Kazmir and tip your cap to Jason Lane and all the others that might be leading to a series win. The 0-1 is on the outside corner, no balls and two strikes, a series win by the opposition. The Skeeters are going to be heading to Camden to take on the River Sharks. That will be taking place, I believe, on Friday. And then the Bluefish will be having their game as the pitch is snapped foul to the right. No balls and two strikes. The Bluefish will be taking on the Patriots. So these two teams taking on New Jersey squads. No balls and two strikes, or rather one ball and two strikes. Two men out. Dominic Ramos It's been mostly Ophelio Castro getting on base. All the other contributors spread apart. The 1-2 served into right field. It's a base and a line drive. So Ramos is on. There's no activity in the Bluefish bullpen. They want Julio DePaul to continue to throw as Cesar digs in. Cesar 1-4-4. And the hit total continues to rise. 14-5, the final. Lancaster against Somerset. The next toss on the inside corner for a strike, 0-1. Two runs in the first, two more in the second, two in the eighth for Sugar Land. Bridgeport, run in the first. Run on two base hits, three errors. Six runs, 11 hits, two errors. That's what everything is counted for. The next one is slap foul to the left, 0-2. So DePaula gives up two runs now. The runners at first and second are his responsibility because he's still on the mound. And they would still be his responsibility even if he were replaced. Dennis Cesar. So difficult to the Bluefish. He's looking for his fourth straight multiple hit game against the Fish. He had two nights ago, three last night. A great run for Cesar. Fans getting a bit impatient. They want DePaula to throw it. Eventually he will, the 0-2. Swung on and...
I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold bell, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys. It was time to hit the store. But stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Meet Ice Cube.
What's up?
Ice Cube is cold.
No. The coldest.
But one thing just might be colder.
Man, it better not be.
Coors Light has a new two-stage cold-activated label that not only tells you when your beer is cold, but super cold.
Yeah, I know. Super cold. It threw snow on me last time.
It snowed on you?
You better check yourself.
Ice Cube is cold, but Coors Light is super cold. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the real yellow pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting. Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles with you. This call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Roberto Giron is on the hill for the road for the home team. And Eddie Rogers stepping up, followed by Prentice Redmond, Willis Otañez, One point it was a 3-run deficit. Now it's a 5-run margin that the Bluefish have to overcome. Eddie Rogers, Redmond, and Otanya is due up. The Bluefish 1 and the Skeeters 6. The fans have stuck around here for much of the night. And the Bluefish hoping that they can make a big comeback in this contest. It would be epic proportion. The next toss on the outside corner, 0-1. Third baseman, Ofidio Castro, about halfway between the lip of the infield and outfield grasses. Same way with Aaron Bates over at first. And you can tell that the loss of Brock Peterson is impacting this team to a large degree, as the next one is a kite-high fly to left field where it hangs just high enough to where Steve Moss makes the catch. Out number one. As if you're flying a kite out there, it just sails. And it's almost like there's an imaginary guide on a string and it fell right into Moss's glove. One away. Guerin stands in, glove down, the pitch on its way, slips to the inside, misses the corner, 1-0. Prentice Redmond. He is 1-for-2. Homer, walk, 5-3. Next toss, bends to the outside corner, 1-1. Just a great manipulation. First, the fastball inside. Then garners the pitch to the outside corner. We'll see where Guerin decides to leave the next one. It's a chopper to the third base side. And angling forward and throwing on the move, Castro, two away. The Bluefish down to the final out. You wonder how the Bluefish will respond to this. Still one more out to go. But it is possible that the Bluefish will recover well from this trip, understanding that they've been about a 500 team much of this first half, much of the second half, and possibly make that run, starting with a momentum builder against a team that got knocked off almost similar fashion. The next toss is inside, 1-ball, no strikes, with the Skeeters having dominant pitching the same way that the Barnstormers are equating that with the Patriots. The Barnstormers scoring plenty of runs, the difference. Sugar Land scoring enough runs, don't get me wrong. Scored 5 runs minimum in each of the last 3 games. The 1-0 bends inside, 2-balls and no strikes. This Skeeters team is much better than I remember it. And the Bluefish, they certainly miss Brock Peterson. They certainly miss a few bats in the order. They're not going to quit, though. They still have plenty of games remaining as the next toss is inside, 3-balls and no strikes. Still will be 4.5 if the Bluefish lose this game. 4.5 is manageable. But the Bluefish would need to make a run quickly. The 3-0, fastball inside, ball 4. Guerin walks Otañez on 4 pitches. Sends up Luis Lopez. The next time that these two teams will tangle, 2 weeks after Labor Day weekend, which is this coming weekend. So 2 weeks from Friday, Bluefish and Skeeters start a 4-game series. Next toss on the outside corner, 0-1. Bluefish during the first half, a 2-3-game series against the Skeeters at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, and a 4-game trip down to Sugar Land. The 0-1, a high pop behind home plate, foul, well out of play. 0-2. The Bluefish down to the final strike. The Bluefish postgame show coming up following the conclusion of this ball game. The fans getting up and cheering for their hometown team. Garon induces a foul ball. Garon's 0-2. Swallon line drive caught. Ball game is over. And that is symbolic of what has unfolded at the ballpark. Line drives, and the Bluefish just could not come up with many hits tonight. Otañez gets on base once. Prentice Redmond gets on base twice. And Luis Figueroa gets on base once. Two hits and two walks total for the Bluefish offense tonight, and the Bluefish fall by a score of 6-1. The postgame show comes to you right after this on BridgeportBluefish.com.
I call this one best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week. Toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store, but stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Meet Ice Cube.
What's up?
Ice Cube is cold.
No, the coldest.
But one thing just might be colder.
Man, it better not be.
Coors Light has a new two-stage cold-activated label that not only tells you when your beer is cold, but super cold.
Yeah, I know. Super cold. It threw snow on me last time.
It snowed on you?
You better check yourself.
Ice Cube is cold, but Coors Light is super cold. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the Real Yellow Pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Bluefish Baseball back on the air. Perry Miles with you. The final score, 6-1. The Bluefish fell in this contest, and boy, they did not quite expect this kind of run by the Sugar Land Skeeters. Their pitching staff was brilliant throughout this series. Total of 4 earned runs in 52 innings pitched by the Skeeters, dating back to the start of the 4th inning in game 1 of this series. And as a result, the Bluefish fall in this series 4-2. Let's take a quick look at the scoring summary. Home run by Prentice Redmond to left field. Solo shot his 14th of the year. Makes it 1-0. After that, it was all Sugarland. 2-run single, Bubba Bell. Bases loaded. RBI single, Fidel Castro. RBI ground ball, Dominic Ramos to make it 4-1. Back-to-back solo drives, Manny Mejia. He now has 45. Mejia now has 21. Suarez with 27. Lopez is 13th error. Simmons his 3rd and Boyer his 3rd. With Ramos his 8th and Steve Moss his 2nd. Bridgeport left 4 on base. Sugarland with 9. And a double play ball. Iggy Suarez, Ramos, and Aaron Bates. That was 1 on the day. Let's quickly go through Sugarland's lineup. 2 hits and a run for Castro with an RBI. Ramos 2 hits and a run to Ribby for the shortstop Cesar. And Bates each with 1 hit, a hit and 2 ribbies for Bell. a hit, two runs, and a ribby for Mejia Suarez. Two hits and a run with a ribby, a hit and a run for Octavio Martinez, and that was it. Gilbert De La Vara moves to 9-8 on the year, 6 1/3, four earned runs, eight hits, two walks, and four strikeouts. All the damage done early. Julio De Paula, 9 2/3, three hits, two runs, both earned, a walk and a strikeout. Two home runs allowed by De Paula. Kazmir moves to 1-6. It's his first win since September 19th of 2010. When he did so against the Tampa Bay Rays. Eight innings, two hits, a run. It was earned, a walk, and three strikeouts. Roberto Giron, an inning, and one walk. Pass ball from Octavio Martinez. Strikeouts on the day, just a total of eight. Gathright, one. Lopez, two. Ramos, one. Bates, three. Suarez with one. That was it. Walks, five. Redman, Otañez with one for the Bluefish. Castro, two. And Mejia with one. Time of the game, 2 hours and 37 minutes. By the way, Kazmir, He threw very few pitches, 92-59 for strikes, 90 pitches for De La Vara, 57 for strikes, De Paula 39 pitches, 22 strikes, and Giron 13 pitches, 8 strikes on the day. Let's take a look quickly at the Atlantic League scoreboard update. York defeats Southern Maryland 4-1, which means the Bluefish are 4.5 games behind Southern Maryland instead of 5.5, which could have been if had the Blue Crabs won tonight. The River Sharks 5 and the Ducks 3, so they win their second in a row, and they're creeping closer to the Bluefish. Lancaster 14 and Somerset 5, the final from TD Bank Ballpark. ESPN.com for the latest scores and summaries. In women's tennis, Azarenka, Sharapova, Kvitova, Stosur, Na, and Bartoli among the top seeds that move on in the women's bracket. On the men's side, Andy Murray 4-2 in the third set after taking the first two, as the gold medal winner hopes to win the U.S. Open. David Ferrer, Del Potro, Tipsarevic, John Isner also moving on, as Andy Roddick, I believe, will be playing in tomorrow's set. In Major League Baseball, the Yankees fall to the Toronto Blue Jays 8-5, the Mets 3 and the Phillies 2. Angels ahead of the Red Sox 4-1, top of the second inning, runner at second base. Minnesota 9, Seattle nothing, bottom of the 8th, bases loaded. Top of the 8th, Houston trail San Francisco 6-4. The rest of the scores appeared to be in the books. We'll get to them. Dodgers 10 and Colorado 8. Cincinnati a 6-2 winner against Arizona. At San Diego 8 and Atlanta 2. Pittsburgh a 5-0 shutout of St. Louis. White Sox taking care of Baltimore 8-1. Oakland doubling up. Cleveland 8-4. The same goes for Tampa Bay over Texas. And Washington over Miami. All those scores 8-4. Milwaukee 3 and the Cubs 1. Kansas City shuts down Detroit 1-0. We thank you for tuning in to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. For more information about Bluefish Baseball, you can go to the website bridgeportbluefish.com. You can send me an email, perrym86@gmail.com, or you can follow me on Twitter, just me, P. Miles. Just me, P. Miles. The Bluefish fall by a score of 6-1 tonight. They're 22-23 in the second half, 53-62 overall. The Skeeters, 24-23. They are 53-64 overall. The Bluefish have lost 3 in a row. The Skeeters have won 3 straight. The Bluefish will be taking on the Somerset Patriots on Friday. Brad Thompson goes to the hill for the Bluefish. He is expected to go up against right-handed pitcher Darryl McCall. Thompson, 6 starts, 2 complete games, 3-3 with a 4.14 ERA against McCall. 23 games, 13 starts, 2 saves, 7-5 with a 4.70 ERA on the year. The Bluefish fall to 27-32 on the road. They are 13-15 in the month of August. There are 53-62 overall, and they finish up 7-9 against the Skeeters with 4 more games coming up in September. The Bluefish finish the slate at Constellation Field 4-6 against the newest member of the Atlantic League. The final score, the Skeeters 6 and the Bluefish 1. The 6:05 gates open on Friday for Universal Bag Giveaway presented by, or rather, the tote bag giveaway presented by Universal Sales Friday night, 7:05 first pitch, 6:05 the gates will open. For those Bluefish fans that will be unable to make it, you can tune in to BridgeportBluefish.com for the broadcast, 6:45 for the pregame show. For Perry Miles, ta-da for now. We'll be back in Bridgeport for Friday. The final score, the Bluefish fall 6-1. Good night for now from Texas.